Hey!
Hi guys, it's Pure Games today where we're playing Mafia 2, and this is going to be the game that we play a full walkthrough. I don't know what that green thing is on the screen. I don't know if you could see it then. There's like a green outline. If not, oh well. But I don't think it's really an issue. It's not come up again. So, 2K Games, here we go. Presents Mafia 2. So hopefully there won't be any visual issues or anything like that. I wouldn't have thought there is. Might be a little bit of a downgrade. We can sort that out if we really need to. I'm assuming we might be able to go one or two more upgrades on the graphics. It shouldn't be too much of an issue because this will be a better version than the Xbox that I used to play on, that everyone used to love. Maybe when I used to do the robbing stores. I do used to do the little mini challenges where I'd rob
my
stores.
Name is Vito
Scalata. But here we go.
I was born in Sicily in 1925. That little guy's me. I'm standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away. From Sicily, across the ocean, to start a new life in America. Never in my life had I seen anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful. On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment. The American dream. It was more like a nightmare. My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work, and what little money he made mostly went towards booze. Eventually, my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around, we started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop!
Vito, this way! Throw me to bed!
Stop! Hold a shoot!
Shit.
Okay, you bastard. Spread your legs.
Fuck.
And put your hands on the fence.
I'm sorry.
Well, that one time it didn't work out so good. The year was 1943. America was at war, and the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18, and anything seemed better than jail. Who says you can't go home again?
Well, that was the intro of Mafia 2. We're now going to war.
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily, but we got hit by flak and had to bail out, way behind enemy lines. Only three of us made it. If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance. So when Mussolini soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up, we decided to return the favor.
Se nessuno parla,
questo going down.
Eh?
No, no, before, no.
Come on, Vito, save everyone.
All right, Scaletta.
Take the shot!
Allora, traditori! Pensavate di poterci
prendere in giro?
Di tradirci? Avete pensato male!
What the hell
vi facciamo vedere noi!
Take come sono stati!
Okay, we didn't get a headshot very well. Alright, we'll get his weapon in a minute.
They're falling back. Let's move. On me. Shit.
I'm dead. Shit.
Jesus.
Whoa.
I say there's more troops headed this way.
You
and Williams take out that machine gun nest. Then find the prisoners. We're gonna need them. Hey, Scaletta! Over here!
Get away from the door.
Hey, Scaletta! Over here!
Oh, where's my rifle? LB is climb. Becomes very useful light when we're trying to run away from people.
Ain't getting through this.
Especially the cops.
You got a grenade, Scaletta.
Watch it!
Put a grenade through the window!
Have a grenade! Oh, that didn't go too well. There's a guy on fire there. Two people on fire you might want to deal with. Nope, the fire's dealt with them.
Yeah, just about.
Okay, let's
get off your ass and let's move it.
Grab all the ammo you can carry.
Oh!
Oh! Look at this shit.
I love that. So any better rifles? Okay, we'll take that. Is there... there you go. Ammunition, that's all we needed. Okay, breach.
On the stairs! Come on!
He's dead, can't move.
There's upstairs.
That's fine, we'll do it.
Second floor. Scaletta, you take point.
Uccidete gli ostaggi!
Picchiatevi chi!
The door, Scaletta. Kick it in.
Yep, I'm on it.
Arrenditi, o gli faccio saltare.
Oh god. Close that door, maybe.
Shit.
I'm gonna run across.
Come on.
Go. Let's put you back. Oh, these? Oh god, they're gonna be enemy soldiers.
What the hell is that?
Go to rifle.
We gotta keep moving. Get inside.
Okay, run.
Get inside, Scaletta.
I'm gonna die up there. Arrivo nuovo di Vassisti. Fantastico.
Oh, yeah. That's it, you're all going down. Tank? Definitely duck.
Dicevo al mio amico di stare attento.
Fregatene di fare attenzione, fai ciò che ti è stato detto!
Hey! Where the hell do you go?
Bye bye, Vito. Oh no!
Ho sparato, picciotti!
Ma che diavolo sta dicendo? Chi si crede di essere?
Un'offerta da parte!
Levi davvero Don Calò?
La guerra è finita!
Cacetto! Un congè quando Samaretà come cucina.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido trucco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete.
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovesse ascoltare i consigli di noiacci del posto. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete fidarvi di me. Che ne dite, eh?
Don Calò, the head of the Sicilian mob. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day. Why? Because he told them to.
Well, the mob is powerful. Home sweet home. 2 years later, Empire Bay, February 8th, 1945.
A few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Vito! Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
Let's go.
There it is. Empire Bay. Tell the truth, you miss it?
Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods. Not like this place ever done me any favors, but anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry, though. A drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito. Come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes, we're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal, what was it like over there, Andy?
Well, I'm guessing you just broke a law, right?
I kept reading the papers to see what was going on. And you know how much I hate reading.
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Calò.
No shit, Don Calò. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here, wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah, and I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country.
Not quite like that.
Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the US of A and to having you back home.
Salud.
A salud. Chin down. How come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
Nah, I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait. You mean you gotta go back?
Yeah, what'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't want to go back, do you?
Nah, of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here.
Both mother and daughter working for the Yankee dollar.
Hey, Giuseppe. It's Joe. Remember
the music in this game, you know, good. The
guy, I'm gonna
turn it off.
Vito Scaletti. Thanks, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later. Situation is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl. Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, whoa. Did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
Huh? Vito's home for good.
You're welcome. Come on, Fred. You're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you want a ride?
No, thanks. I want to walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
Mom, taxi.
Here we are.
All right, thanks. Good change.
That is right.
Okay, yeah. I botched that. I didn't know.
Fire is...
Oh, well. Right.
And since we've no place to go...
Yeah, I know what a mini-map is.
No, let
him go! Yeah, we'll be right back.
And it doesn't show signs of stopping.
It's just one lousy beer!
Corn for Papa.
The lights are turned. Sorry about the Christmas music, guys, but,
let it snow.
Well... Yeah, you could say it is August, and we're getting there, we're not, you know, we're way far away from Christmas yet. I've seen so many Christmas outfits already. It's only August. To Mama's apartment.
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito. Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I thought I'd never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
So sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Benedice, Signore, la manciata, che per tua volontà. Stiamo ricevendo, provvede nel cuore che ci dobbiamo chiamare. Per Cristo nostro
Signore. Okay, that's a very awkward dinner.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
Oh, this will be interesting. Well, okay then.
I'll see you 2 in the morning.
Sleep well, mio bambino.
The next day.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe! You want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly.
No.
Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Papalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him. Work hard like you were your papa. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie a Dio.
Okay, guys, so we've got a few things to do today, but we're going to end this episode right here, right now. And in the next video, we'll be going to see Joe getting our papers and things like that and getting more into the Mafia. We'll hopefully be able to start getting weapons and getting into a little bit of crime where we can then go and do little mini challenges like rob as many stores in 20 minutes as you can, see how much heat you can have on you and things like that. But that's all for another video, so I'll see you guys in the next one. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, press the notification button to help with instant notifications, and we'll see you guys in the next video.